usually dishing the dirt on the big stars, but this morning he is dishing up a meal that the stars like to make themselves. Hello, Craigie Bennett.
Oh, hello, Sarah. Some might be thinking, what on earth is he doing in the kitchen? Well, I reckon that gossip and gourmet go so beautifully together. And frankly, you don't get a figure like mine unless you eat. And that often means cooking, doesn't it?
Mine too. Well, or the way I did it.
Oh, well, hang on. I mean, you actually do have a reason.
Yes. Now, what are you
making?
What's
happened to you can't happen to me at this point. Though science is probably working.
Too much meatloaf. And you're making meatloaf today.
I am. I'm making Joan Crawford's very famous meatloaf. Melt in the mouth. Absolutely delicious.
Okay.
And this truly is her recipe. And she was one of those great dinner party throwers, you
know. Oh, was she? I love that.
Oh, and had absolutely everybody there back in the day. So here's how we begin. That, by the way, is I got up this morning and I made it. So we'll show it plated up shortly.
No, I am mixing.
That'd be fabulous, Denise.
Now, hang on. So what's in here? You've got three different types of
mince. Yes, what we've got is 750 grams. Of beef mince,
yep.
And then we've got pork and veal mince, 250 grams each, mm-hmm. So that comes to just over a kilo. This will serve six. I'm glad you got your gloves on, Denise. Now, a little tip when we're mixing the meat for a meatloaf, be gentle, because otherwise you can make it a little tough. Now, what Joan does... We're not making meatballs, although we could.
No, so, I'm just being gentle.
I know you are. Good, yes. Treat it like a silkworm. Two eggs go into here, like that. Just another one there, Denise.
Okay. Then.
And let me add everything, and then you can begin mixing it.
So
that's
a couple
right.
Of eggs. You've got some milk.
Yes. What I've got here is she loves milk, and that tenderises it. That is not in the Joan Crawford original recipe,
but I've
goosed
it
up
down,
a bit. Yeah. Well, I've got to be honest with you. Just on the sly, hers was so dry. I think she mistook it for a martini because she was fond of a drink. So I've goosed it up a little. You see. Now some breadcrumbs in there, round about
They're
a cup
not panko.
Of seasoned breadcrumbs. They're not, but you could probably use panko. Ooh. Now, we've got one big chopped onion, nice and finely chopped, not cooked, just raw. Mm-hmm. So that goes in.
Shall I start mixing yet?
Yep, you can start mixing now because we're going to add some milk goes in there, round about a cup of milk. Then, she loved a little Leon Perrin's Worcestershire sauce.
She used to have that with ice cubes.
Yeah, that's right. And a lot of vodka. You'll note there's a recurring theme here. We're adding a little bit of tomato sauce, just a... Squirt.
Oh, do a bit more.
And some HP sauce, which has the lovely tamarind and stuff in. Ooh. So there you go, Denise. Give that all a nice big mix up. Little seasoned salt as well.
What about the eggs? Are the eggs going in or are they?
Oh, they're hard cooked eggs. I'll tell you how that goes.
We're going to have blind hair.
That's it, darling. Now give that a good big mix.
I am.
I know, there's no need to snap. But, you know, time's always precious, isn't it? Now, what we're going to pop a little base on the tray here like that.
Yes.
That's it. Now, that would be beautifully mixed, of course. Then with our hard-cooked eggs, we're going to do one like that, one like that.
That's what
they One like that, one like that. Then the rest of it goes over
So it's
the
a bit like
right
a Scottish
right.
egg, but not...
Yes, it is. That's right. Isn't it beautiful?
Oh, right.
Look
I didn't
at that.
What
there
sorry,
we
that's
go.
The blind hair. They can't... They're in there, but they can't see
Hang on, Denise.
Out.
What are we doing here, love? There we sorry. Go. I know Ding Dong does dinner.
Now, Craig,
and beautifully.
How long would you put this in the oven for?
This goes into the oven, just to form it into a nice meatloaf like that. This goes into the oven, Sarah, for around about an hour, 20 minutes.
Sorry, 20 minutes?
An hour and 20 minutes, yeah. And what you do...
You've got an egg poking at the bottom.
It's annoying.
Would it be better in a pan?
No, just like this. And then you tip about a cup of water over that.
Yes.
And then partway through, you glaze it with a little of the HP sauce, a little of the tomato sauce, and a little of the Leon Perrin sauce. And that is how it turns out.
We are going to taste this and see how it is. And hopefully it's not too dry like Joan's.
Oh, no, mine's moist, I promise you. My meatloaf, I mean.
We're taking a very quick break. See you in a sec. Meatloaf. How is it? Let's taste it.
And
let's
it's
have a
not
taste.
Dry, I promise
it's
you. Look at that.
It's delicious. It's beautiful.
We're going to pop this on the website. Jack Thompson, we love you.
We do, Jack.